Hey, welcome to the last video of this tutorial series. In the background, you can see the final result of my tutorial. You can get all the assets, code, the complete Unity project on my GitHub account. In this last video, I want to show you how I created the meshes in Blender, the changes that I have done to my scripts, and how the shader for the mesh animation works. So yeah, let's jump into the first chapter of this video. I opened up Blender, and here you can see all the meshes that I created for my block building. To create all of these geometries, I first created some basic elements. Let's zoom to one of those walls here and let's enable material mode. I created some of those basic elements like a single wall, a corner, let's say a floor element. And then I combined those elements to create all the possible variations, like this corner element here, which has a door on one side and a wall on the other side. Or let's say these roof corners here. It was a lot of work. I had to create like, let's say 80 different meshes. And then after I created one of those meshes, let's take this here for example, I used my copy and rotate script to create all the different variations or the different rotation variations of these meshes. And then I did some small changes to make them a little bit more unique or irregular, like for example on this one here. Basically it's four times the same mesh, but for this one here I added a small flower pot. It's the same for, like, let's say the walls here. Those four walls here are basically the same, but except for this one here. This, I guess it's the southern wall, it has a small balcony. I created those variations by adding some plants here on the window for this corner element, or by opening and closing windows for some of the elements. For example, on this one here, one of the windows is closed, the other one is open. And this helps to make it look a bit irregular or a bit, it helps making it look more alive. So basically that's it for the modeling part. I don't really want to make a modeling tutorial in Blender. There are a lot of modeling tutorials out there, so I don't really see any purpose for another modeling tutorial, because it's pretty straightforward box modeling. So now let's have a look at the changes that I have done to our scripts. I modified the corner meshes script. So let's fire up VS Code. In the getCornerMesh function of the corner meshes script, I just added another else function to check for the height value. If the height value equals the level height, then it should give me the corner element with a prefix value of 2. So then it gives me the corner elements that are basically just a roof element. Then I added a sound effect. That sound effect gets played when grid elements get activated and deactivated. And I'm changing the pitch of the audio level by the level of our grid elements. I'm using the coordinate y value of the grid element to change the audio pitch. And that creates this nice bing 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 sound when grid elements get enabled and disabled. And then finally I added an update function to the corner elements, and I'm using this update function to play the dissolving animation of the shader, or the not, it's not only dissolving, it's also the appearing animation, but I just named it dissolve. The main part of the update function only gets executed if the animating bool is set to true, so it's not, so the performance impact of the update function is not that heavy. And there's another bool in the corner element script that's named reverse, and it just defines if the dissolve animation, or I shouldn't really call it dissolve animation, more like the shader animation is played forward or backward. So if the element appears or if it disappears. And both bools get set when I'm changing the bit mask value of the corner element. And if the next bit mask value is 0, while the current bit mask value is not 0, it plays it backward, so it plays it reversed. So here's the shader that I'm using for the house. It's using the Lambert shading model, and it has two texture and one float input. The first texture is the main diffuse texture. The second texture is the dissolve mask, which defines how the dissolve effect looks like. And then there's the dissolve float value that basically controls the dissolving effect. The animation for the, or the dissolving animation is done in both the vertex and the fragment shader. In the vertex shader, I'm moving the vertices based on the normal direction, so I'm just pushing them outwards. And while I'm pushing them outwards to the dissolve value, I'm clipping the fragments inside of the fragment shader with the dissolve value and our dissolve texture. And yeah, basically that's it. It's a quite simple shader, but it creates a nice effect. There are also some parts of the shader that are currently commented out. You can uncomment them to add some cube map reflections to your scene. For this you need a reflection mask that defines things like windows or metal elements and a simple cube map, and then you can have some nice reflections on your windows. I tried it, it looked okay, but it was not what I expected. I like the a bit more flat look more. So basically, that's it for this video series. I hope you have enjoyed it. For me, it was the first time of doing a YouTube tutorial. It was both fun and challenging. And I guess I will maybe do some other ones, but currently I have no idea what to do. Also have a lot of things to do at work, so maybe I'll find some time to create a new tutorial series. Maybe I will do some smaller videos concerning maybe Blender or Unity. Or even Unreal, currently doing some Unreal stuff at work, and it's fun, but it's also very challenging. So maybe see you in another video. Bye!